Hello, gainers and grateful ones. Ralphie here with another round of fitter philosophy, all wrapped up in a traditional online internet-based video blog. I'm in my little studio at the moment, and I'm going to kind of carry on from one of the subjects that I touched in my last review, which was a walk and talk discussing acquired knowledge and learning, and how there's a significant difference to us in the quality of our life between the knowledge that we get through the educational system, which is imposed upon us, which can either be useful for functioning in a society like reading, writing, spelling, arithmetic, and some basic mathematics, and also the, at times, disingenuous, fictional education that we get in our history classes, which either tell us blatant, disingenuous lies, or they just fudge over certain facts and details and give us a sanitized version which suits the dogma of the age in which we live. And something I covered on in that video was freedom. And I'm coming back to explore that theme from a personal, physical, philosophical perspective. Freedom is an interesting one because it's a very emotive word, and it carries certain symbols along with it. Say CND symbol, the Campaign for Nuclear Disarmament. That is a symbol which is associated with freedom in its vague, generalized sense. And also the anarchist symbol, another distinctive and kind of similar symbol, which goes back, by the way, tens of thousands of years. You will find these symbols on rock art. They're nothing new. Many, many symbols with heavy, heavy meanings have modern interpretations, but these are recent phenomena and they do not reflect the ancient interpretations, which have got a very different meaning. And knowledge such as this, you don't get to find at school. You find when we go on our own voyage of self-improvement and learning and improving our capacity for thought. This is very important when we examine the subject of freedom, because if we look at the movies, freedom is, you know, getting drunk, having a party, you know, having a reason to engage in a battle, having a notion that things are going to be better when the probability is that they won't. It is a word which is useful for sidestepping rational, clear, logical thought, and also consideration for other human beings. And I can tell you right now, there is only a handful of species, but I would say that the humanoid collective comes in the top 10 comfortably as one of the most self-harming species in the known universe. Thought I'd share that with you. Thought you'd find that useful to be aware of. Now, freedom. The bland, or the negative side of freedom is, well, not to be suffering, not to feel pain, not to be lacking for anything. Very simplistic, because sometimes we feel pain because it actually helps us grow. The pain of certain emotional situations, a loss and a bereavement. To have things just good all the time becomes numbing. There's no point of comparison. And the risk is that one morphs from living into existing, and increasingly in a society which self-medicates so heavily. I'm talking about global society now. This is a very real risk. The emotional dumbing down of the species, not just the intellectual dumbing down. It's a very real risk. Free stuff. This is what people want with freedom. A lot of people that don't think it through carefully, they just want free stuff. Want more money, bigger car, more food, more time. Not saying time to do what, just more time, more freedom. And when you get freedom, things are just better. There's no tangible reason, it just is. More of everything. This comes in with free stuff. People love free stuff. It's one of the black art hooks of marketing. Buy one, get one free. You've paid for both, but we'll make it look like it's just the price for one, and then you'll get the other one free. There you go. How about free offers? You know, discounted, only for this month. Hurry, if you miss it, you've missed it, and once it's gone, it's gone. All these little hooks that help us think we've got the freedom to get more out of the money we spend when we don't. It's like going into a coffee shop, the freedom to have 50 different varieties of virtually the same product in slightly different cups. Some people will spend a few minutes looking at their freedom options. Will I have it skinny? Will I have it will I have it frappuccino? Will I have my coffee this way, that way, this flavor, that flavor? Superficial, shallow, and time wasting. A coffee is a coffee, and a little dose of caffeine is all we're really looking for at the end of the day, because without caffeine, coffee tastes shit. Ice cream, another classic example. More of everything. You go into the ice cream shop, it doesn't matter if an ice cream shop has one very good quality variety of vanilla. People are looking for those options. Strawberry, chocolate, lemon, orange, nut, more chocolate, another variety of chocolate, coconut, some of these exotic, and perhaps even some sorbets. So going into an ice cream shop, they all taste good. They all taste good, but we've got this illusion that we've got whole loads of choice, which are basically down to little flavor sensations, which are more often than not put there by oil extracts, chemicals. It's real life. Meanwhile, as we are distracted by these superficial options of freedom, real responsibilities of freedom in the social, in the family, in the social community, in the wider society, these are just automatically delegated to the least competent people for the job, who are bought and sold like cattle. But it's part of the human condition. We deal with it, and that is not going to change. No kickback. In other words, freedom is you can live your life and just be happy and nothing's going to go wrong. You won't suffer any misfortune, have bad luck, or have any accountability for the shit that you impose on others, that we impose on others. This is the shallow reading of freedom. It is permeated through media, in particular films, books, newspapers and magazines. It is spoon-fed to us, and we have to break the magic spell of its hold on us, because it is in fact a form of controlling occultism. And no accountability, well, I mentioned that. That's the key part of freedom, is it's just vague, fuzzy happiness. But what freedom really is, it's when you get stoic about it, philosophical about it, when we start taking responsibility for the caliber of our own thoughts. And it does take practice, it doesn't happen overnight, and it can be frightening. I'm telling you right now, it can be seriously challenging. We have to look at ourselves as we really are, and not at ourselves as we generally think we are. Living for real. Tackling emotions, the emotion of guilt when you see people sleeping in the street. Don't negate it. It's freedom. That is the freedom to have more consciousness. And it's something that we should all develop further. The positive aspect of humanity. Because the bottom line is, when you look at species around the planet who are collective and work together, they prosper. And they become stronger. Species that segregate, separate, downsize, downscale relationships and meaningful connections, they're weaker species. Personal growth. Personal growth is saying, how can I live a better quality of life with less stuff? Seeing as old people, when they get old, they've got a house full of stuff, all the possessions needing dusting that no longer have significance and meaning. What really matters is a few photographs, the memory book, places we've been, people we've known, and all this stuff that's been accumulated that we've been encouraged to buy and keep buying and keep earning to keep buying. That's not freedom. That is a form of bondage. Connecting with humanity. This is really quite important. Whether we are loners or sociable people, and often we're a bit of both, it's knowing how to value and appreciate and enjoy and make the best use of our alone time, where we can simply get grounded with the natural world, that we can step aside. And that will be a subject of my next walk and talk video, by the way. The skill of stepping aside for a while, even for 5 minutes, or 5 hours, or 5 months, or 5 years. The options are endless. But stepping aside is something that comes with the self-confidence, the growing self-confidence of understanding what freedom really is. Freedom is connecting with humanity, positively, knowing that we are not here in complete isolation. Sure, the some of us could live on another planet entirely on our own, comfortably, but not that many. Humanity is a human being's point of reference for the perspective, support, and endorsement of freedom. Because with the freedom of the self becomes the role model for the freedom of society, development and growth and evolution. I conclude with one of my own little quotes in freedom, and I hope you've enjoyed this little monologue. I do give these things some thoughts now and again when I'm drinking whiskey and having walks in the fresh air, and preferably in the sunshine. Here's my quote. It is. I've even initialed it to verify it as my own. Freedom is desire to surpass existence and live more meaningful to grow. Meaningfully to grow. There we go. I'll say that again, just one more time. Freedom is a desire to surpass existence and to live more meaningfully to grow. I hope you've enjoyed this. Pop back again soon, gainers and growers and fitter philosophers. And I'll be out in my walk and talk discussing the skills, the stoic exercise of stepping aside. See you soon.